sannavadanam yaye.
State of ignorance, the concept about the world is real or false. Real for an ignorant person, maybe a mumukshu, maybe a jidnyasu, but still he doesn't know the Atma Sarupa, Brahma Sarupa. For him, the Jagat is what? Real. Even in the state when the Jagat was mistaken as real Satyam, by effort, meaning sadhana chatushtampati, thereafterwards shravana, manana, nididhyasana, fighting with the ajnana karya, the so-called real Jagat, he got the Atma Jnana and Nishtha, that firm abidance in the Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana, this person has got. And now, on the basis of this knowledge, what is his concept about the Jagat, Satya or Mithya? Now, in the wake of Jnana Nishtha, Jagat is Mithya. Why? He knows his Swarupa, and earlier Ajnana is removed. When the Jagat is now discovered to be Mithya, that Mithya Jagat, is it capable of destroying his knowledge? When the Jagat was mistaken as real Satyam, it could not do, and he, this person, could overpower it and gain the knowledge. When he has discovered the Jagat as false Mithya, where is the question of the Jagat, which is Ajnana Karya, effect of ignorance to eliminate or destroy the knowledge, next to impossible. So that is what is explained with the help of an illustration. An emperor who fought with the army of the enemies, destroyed all of them, and now what is there on the battlefront is only the dead bodies of all these people. Is he going to get frightened by seeing these corpses on the battlefront? Real fear was when they were alive and they were giving a tough fight to this emperor. Now, in fact, all the dead body, what do they show? It shows his might and strength, a glory that he could fight and finish all these enemies. So it is a glory. Likewise, to a jnana nishtha, a jnani who has got firm abundance of knowledge, he says the mithya jagat is a glory and not the one which can remove his knowledge. So this is what was shown so far. Now a question may come, so what? Do you agree? What? Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana cannot be destroyed or dismissed by Ajnana, nor by its effect Ajnana Karya, the Jagat. Agreed. So what? So what? This is the outcome. Let us see. Ya eva mati shurena bodhena na viyojyate Pravrutyava nivrutyava Deha digatayasya kim Anvaya, first line as it is. Yaha evam atishurena bodhena na viyujyate Asya deha digataya Pravrutya va nivrutya va kim syat. Pravrutya va nivrutya va kim syat. The one, yaha, who is this person? One who has got not only the knowledge, but the firm abidance in knowledge, jnana nishtha, one who has got such a person. Atishurena bodhena na viyujyate. That early figurative expression of earlier, that illustration of emperor is kept here. Atishurena bodhena na viyujyate. Never get separated from the bodha. What is bodha? Atma bodha, Brahma bodha, knowledge of Atma identical with Brahma. Na viyujyate doesn't get separated means the one from whose vision Brahma Swarupa, Atma Swarupa never gets extinct means one who is able to have the anusandhana, appreciation of Brahma Swarupa, Atma Swarupa all along. That much abidance is there. Na viyujyate, na, so, doesn't get separated. And that bodha is called as Atishura. So brain is what? In front of that knowledge, everything is getting reduced to what? False, like this, a conflagration reduces everything to ashes. Like that, this knowledge which this directly makes reveals the Brahma Swarupa and the so-called Jagat hitherto that was there has no true existence at all. Maybe experience, but has no true existence. So therefore, Atishurena Bodhena. Another thing, Atishura, because this knowledge cannot be terminated. It cannot be dismissed by any other knowledge, the final knowledge. Final knowledge to such an extent that, you see, any knowledge has to be gained by pramana, means of knowledge. This is the final knowledge, and such a knowledge, it swallows the pramana itself. Not only swallows the pramana, it swallows the pramata also. Who is the pramata? The one who knows, knower, the means of knowledge. If the knowledge here, the person's mind is absorbed in the Swarupa, neither the Vedanta Pramana is there, nor the one I know is there. If I know Pramata is there, foul. That knowledge is no knowledge of Atma, because still you are knower, it's Savikalpa. Knower is there, Pramata, Prameya is there. Maybe as a step it is required, but at the final stage it is not so. So therefore, Atishura Bodha, Satya Bodha, which dismisses rest all of the thing. So Naviyujate, one who doesn't get separated, means one who never loses the sight of such knowledge. He says, for Asya, now see, be careful, I am repeatedly bringing to your notice. This is not a lip service which anyone and everyone can repeat. The person who is declaring all this is the one who has not only got the knowledge, but firm absorption in the knowledge to such an extent, he has got that nirvikalpa samadhi and firm abidance for a long period of time, and one because of which he has nothing to gain nor anything to be done. Only such persons we are talking. Even not a person who has got knowledge, but still because of habitual identifying the body, dehatadatma is there, who still has to take to nididhyasana, that person also doesn't count in picture as far as this description is concerned. One who has even crossed the stage of nididhyasana, shravana manana already over, nididhyasana also he has taken to such a perfection that he doesn't need nididhyasana any further, that person's declaration or his consideration, all these are being given. He says, in the case of such person, asya, dehadi gata gataya, pravrutyava, nivrutyava, kim bhavet, kim syat. Now such a person, if he takes to pravrutti, doing some karma, what level you are doing karmas? Dehadi gata, related to the body. So body adi for mind and vak. Actions at the physical level, oral level and mental level. So this, by this karma, gataya, pravrutya, by the positive karma, performing something, or nivrutya, that means withdrawing the karmas at this three levels, kim bhavet means what ishta he is going to get or what anishta he is going to get, what is he going to gain or what is he going to lose, that means nothing is going to gain or lose, means he is totally unaffected by performance or non-performance of karma. Karmas are not going to add something to him, nor they are capable of taking away something from him. So therefore, so that is, ishta or anishta is not possible by performance or non-performance of karma. So he is totally independent of this. So that means, one who is jnana nishtha, or otherwise also called as jivan mukta. So he may take to action, he may not take to action. So why he takes to action or why he doesn't take to action, it is not his will, it is governed by prarabdha. either prarabdha of the jnani or it can be samashti prarabdha, the totality prarabdha. Because here is a jnani, the majority expects something and it is a law of Ishvara, so that it gets governed by that. So either individual prarabdha of the jnani or the samashti prarabdha, that guides whether performance or non-performance, pravritti or nivritti on the part of such a jnana nishta jivan mukta. In this context, one may say, if such a jnani may perform or may not perform karma, he may take to pravritti or he may take to nivritti, he is unaffected, why not ajnani also? Why do you insist that ajnani should necessarily take to karma? Let ajnani also take to nivritti. Pravritti is what? Taking to karma. But you insist that ajnani should take to karma, take to pravritti and never to nivritti. He should never desist from karma. Why do you say? If jnani can take to either of them, let ajnani also take either of them, pravritti or nivritti. No. Ajnani should necessarily take to karma, let us say. Pravritta vagravo nyayo bodahinasya sarvatha svargaya vapavargaya yati tavyam yato nrubhihi. Anvaya bodahinasya sarvatha pravrittau agraha nyayah, nyayo by sandhi, nyayah, bodhahinasya sarvatha pravrittau agraha nyayah yataha nrubhihi svargaya va apavargaya yati tavyam yataha nrubhihi svargaya va apavargaya yati tavyam. Now in the case of such a person, who is he? Bodhahinaha. Who is bodhahinaha? One has no bodha, means who? Buddhu, that's all. Buddhu can be otherwise also. In the, from the vyavaharic standpoint also buddhu, but even from paramarthic standpoint buddhu, because he has no bodha. Bodha is what? Brahma jnana, atma jnana, atma bodha, one who has not got. So bodhahinasya sarvatha, by all means, no exception, no appeal, pravrittau agraha nyayah. Agraha, that is emphasis, persistence, insisting that this ajnani who is bodhahina sarvata pravrittau in taking to karma, nyayaha means fully justified. What it means is, an ajnani should necessarily take to karma. Why? Why concession for jnani and you are asking ajnani to take to karma? Fine. What is the goal of life of an ajnani? What this ajnani wants? Better ask him only, because long list is there. we can't reply. A long list is there what he wants. List about the things here, and if he is astikaha here, after. He has got endless desire, and if even no psychology will tell. A person who has got endless desire better take to the fulfillment of the desire, otherwise the fellow will be the most miserable individual. By legitimate means, of course, by legitimate means, better he strive for to fulfill them. He may or he may not fulfill, he may succeed or may not, better take to the means of fulfilling them. So therefore, this person, that means, what is his goal of life? That he should take to Purushartha. What type of Purushartha? Better take higher and higher Purushartha. If you want to know what this person is interested, watch what the fellow does on Sunday. What this Ajnani does on Sunday, better watch. If not anything, what? Click on channel TV, this TV, that TV, already is there. What does it mean? Otherwise, he has got many other preoccupations, is it not? So, chup nahi baithega. Why chup nahi baithega? Chup bait nahi sakta hai, the fellow can't sit quietly because the desire for this and that is there. So long as his desires are gurgling, it is impossible to keep quiet. So that being the case, so this should be re-channelized, directed towards higher and higher pursuit, not lower pursuit as such. So as per Shastra, what is the higher pursuit? Straight away moksha may not be because the fellow doesn't have proper vairagya. So better entice the person by swarga. Hey, running after the enjoyments here, there are better things. Why? The enjoyments here are mixed with sorrow, diseases and many problems. But if you go to heaven, what is there? Maja hi maja. So, no disease, number one, no cancer there, no heart attack, no blood pressure, okay. No sort, mamla hi nahi hai. Okay. That's the thing. Other thing they say, see, in heaven, they say there is no hunger and thirst. Okay. Suppose, here if hunger and thirst were not there, how nice it would have been. I don't mean no hunger, thirst because of disease. That is a different problem. You will have to go to a doctor. Not that way. If this body was designed by Parameshwara in such a way that the recurring cycle of hunger and thirst is not there, were not to be there, you know what would happen? 75% of the problem would not have been there. Other 25% will be there because of many other desires, but 75% of the problems would not have been there. So ask anyone, hey, why do you do pet ke vaste? First thing, pet ke vaste. Afterwards, after pet is over, other things come afterwards. So, that is that. Peti, etc. afterwards. First pet. So, that being the case, now you say, so, there they say, there is no hunger and thirst. All music, dance and all that, maja maja hi hai. So, this fellow falls for it. And where do you find Vedas only? Why Vedas give? Vedas tell because means of accomplishing these are not your currency notes here. You have to earn entirely different type of currency. What is that currency? Punya. And to earn punya, the person has to live a life of dharma. Earlier if you ask him, hey, avoid adharma, take to dharma, he will not take to. But when the bait of swarga is there, the carrot of swarga is held in his in front of him, slowly he takes to a life of dharma, means adharma he avoids. And by that, a life of dharma, punya means, if he in course of time, some maturity may dawn and he may even try to inquire the nature of swarga also. Maybe I go to this swarga, how long I am going to be there? Who told me that swargas are there? Vedas. The same Vedas tell us dakshine punne martyalokam vishan. Once your capital of punya is over, you return to earth only. So because of little maturity and developed viveka, he says, I may go there and have some holiday there, but again I have to come back. And when I come back, the same good old samsara starts. Is there no total freedom from this? The Vedas come and tell, if you are serious, yes, I have got an answer. What is that? total freedom from this is that, what is it? Know your Swarupa. Your Swarupa is such that Paramananda Swarupa, no trace of sorrow whatsoever. So for that purpose, the higher goals of life can be two. To begin with, when the maturity is not that enough, Vairagya is not that enough, Swargas. If the person has got Vairagya, Moksha by gaining Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. So, an Ajnani has to struggle, strive for to gain either of the, from that standpoint, and if go either of these to be taken to, what is the first step? Karma. Either for Swarga, he has to take to karma prescribed by the Vedas. Even for Moksha, what is required? Antakarna Shuddhi. Antakarna Shuddhi means karma yoga is involved. Bhakti is involved. Karma and bhakti with karma, Ishwar Arpana Buddhi is required. Karma has to be taken to. So in either case, Ajnani should necessarily take to karma. So therefore he says, for Bodhahinasya, the one who has not got the Atma Jnana, Sarvatha Pravruttau Agraha Nyaya, that persistent that he should necessarily take to karma is fully justified. Why? Yataha, because of this reason. What is that? Nrubhihi, by human being, Swargaya va Apavargaya Yati Tauvam. All human beings should strive for, put forth effort, either for Swarga. If the Vairagya is not strong enough, they have to put for effort for gaining Swarga karmas. They have to take to karmas to gain the Swarga. Or Apavargaya. Apavarga is Moksha. If he has got maturity, better put forth effort for Moksha. Now we may say, Moksha means where karma comes. In the beginning, karmas do come. Because karma yoga is there. Karma yoga without karma is not possible. See, even Navida Bhakti also comes under the category of karma only. But it is not bhakti for getting something, no barter deal. Bhagavan, I do this much of bhakti, therefore what? You grant me all this. Charter of demand is there. Charter of demand, don't think that only union leaders produce. Everyone produces. So Bhagavan is bored about this charter of demand. You know? Every infinitesimal second also he has got demand from how many? Endless people, you know, interesting thing is that. Terminate and devotees have foolish desire. A devotee of Satya Sai Baba prayed itself. Swami, I would like to know your state of mind for a while. Means what is going on in your mind for a while? He laughed. He laughed because the fellow had invited trouble. He laughed. Okay, he said fine. And he gave a sample experience of just for 5 minutes. Your wrath. All people amiss. Our people are not seen clamoring of this thing. I want that, I want this, please take away this sorrow of that, please take away that sorrow. And enough of it. That is what he said. And that is why he is Bhagavan. Because Parameshwara's job is all charter of demand will go to. And when they are, even in terms of, so that means mental, that sauskar, etc. When they are actually, that means actually they are not received, how much it will be? So that in the case, so that fellow, that is, it will be like this only. So that is this, that is the bhakti should not be in terms of demanding this and that. So Bhagavan also is bored of that. So that in the case, bhakti should necessarily be for antakarna shuddhi. Or if you want to speak in terms of bhakti, for Bhagavan only. Whether you say Bhagavan or Brahma Swarupa, in reality both are one and the same. So therefore, Nribihi Yasma, because these people, human beings, What should they do? Swargaya va apavargaya yatitavyam. They should put forth effort either to gain heaven or moksha. In either case, in the initial stages, karma is indispensable. Fine. Next query is like this. Ajnani should necessarily take to karma. Agreed. Jnani may take to pravritti karma, or he may withdraw from karma, take to nivritti. There is no emphasis on either of these. But suppose this jnani who is a jnana nishtha, he is found among ajnanis, what he should do? Where this jnani is there, all are who? Ajnani dozi. Should this jnani take to karma or? You already told, by taking to karma, he is not going to lose anything. By performing karma, he is not going to gain anything. There is no effect on him. But he is surrounded, or he is found to be amidst the ajnanis who have to take to karma. How the jnani, such a person who is a jnanishta, should conduct? He says, Bhagavad Gita, so those who have to take to karma, don't with ajnanis, don't go and tell them, look, karma is binding, better don't take to, don't tell them. Buddhi bheda means their shraddha, their conviction should not be unsettled. On the contrary, what you do? You encourage them to take to karma by yourself taking to karma and demonstrating how the karma has to be taken to. Also, loka sangrahame vapi sampashan kartumarase. Lord Krishna himself has said, Arjuna, you may not need karma, at least for loka sangraha, performance of karma on your part is going to help the humanity. For example, Arjuna has to fight the Mahabharata war. Arjuna has, Arjuna has developed vairagya and he wanted to take sannyasa. Bhiksham api aloke shreyaya told. He wanted to take to sannyasa. If his vairagya was perfect, and even if he takes to sannyasa, he is not going to lose for because of not fighting the Mahabharata war. But for the majority of the people, to establish dharma and put down the adharma that Duryodhana signifies, Mahabharata war was indispensable, because without Arjuna there was no match for Kaurava's army. So that was loka sangraha. If Arjuna fights the Mahabharata war, Duryodhana and Kaurava's army can be defeated, dharma will be established, it is good for humanity. That is loka sangraha, the good of the humanity. Like that, jnani either not to unsettle the conviction of the ajnani in performance of action, karma, or for the good of the people, when he is amid the ajnani, let him take to karma, he is not going to lose anything. Vidvanste tadrusham madhe.
Vidvanste tadrusham madhe.
Tishte tadanurodhataha.
Tishte tadanurodhataha.
Kayena manasa vacha.
Kayena manasa vacha.
Karoti vakila kriyaha.
Karoti vakila kriyaha.
Tadrusham madhi vidvan tishte. I hope you know the sandhi breaking. Vidvan ket tadrisham, sandhi breaking, anvaya. Tadrisham madhye vidvan tishthet ket tad anurodhatah kayena manasa vacha अखिलाः क्रियाः करोति एव, अखिलाः क्रियाः करोति एव. इफ द ज्ञानी इज फाउंड लाइक दिस तादृशां मध्ये, amidst such types of people, what are those? Who wants to gain swarga? Who have got many desires to be fulfilled? And jnani is found amidst these people. What he should do? Tadrisham madhe vidvan tishthet ke. If a jnani happens to be amidst such people, what should he do? Tadanurodhataha. In accordance with what these ignorance people are expected to do in terms of karma, physical level, oral level or mental level. So that is what he says, kayena manasa vacha, physically, mentally and orally, akhilaha kriyaha karoti eva. He does all karmas. Why? To set an example for these. That's what Lord Krishna said. Name parthasti kartavyam trishulokeshu. Arjuna, I have no karma, no duties in the entire world. Vartayeva cha karmani. Still I am engaged with karma. Why? I am a Shrestha Purusha. So Krishna was held in high esteem by and if And Krishna need not take to karma. He can always get lost in his swarupa. And suppose he sits in meditation with a clothed eye, what others will do? Yadyadacharati sreshtaha tatta devetaro janaha. They also will sit with clothed eyes. Okay. Not what Krishna is doing, they can't do that. Right? But they can certainly sit with the clothed eye. And after what will they do? After some time open the eyes and see here and there. Is anybody looking at me that I am meditating? Any camera is ready to take my photograph? Otherwise, so he will look at the clock. So when is the lunch time? When is the tea time, etc. So that Krishna can get lost in his swarupa for ages. But this fellow can't, because he doesn't, this fellow doesn't know what is swarupa. So only he will physically imitate. Is he at gain or loss? At least some karma had he done, he would have got something. Here ubhaya bhrashtaha. So therefore he says, so akhilaha kriyaha karoteva. Just to set an example to those people, or for the good of the people, he does, because if the jnani does, they get benefited. See, that is the sampradaya, because of it, you know, these Shankaracharyas of this four mutts, etc., they do karma. You know why? Because of their status, they have to guide the people in dharma and karma also. Certain anushthana they do, puja, etc., they do. But the problem is, only that goes on there, but nothing about the Vedanta. That is the modern problem. Not only that, even if, I was told, even if, you know, few years back, Sringeri Shankaracharya was for Chaturmasa at Chembur. So he thought, let me teach something about Vedanta. So that is, he is supposed to do that. One day, he took something, and one of my students, who was exposed to Vedanta for ages, he happened to attend. And he told me, Swamiji, he had taken in a very simple manner, not a very high level, etc., at an ordinary level, some Vedanta he had taken. It seems afterwards all people came and told, Maharaj, this is not meant for us. They are only accustomed with what? Pada puja karo. Aur kya hai wo? mantra. What is that coconut is called what? All the mantra akshat leo, or only and some are the what? Archana and puja, etc. Then only they know nothing more than that. And the problem was, he stopped it also, it says. Actually, he should have persisted, because see, look here. Medicine is to be determined by the doctor or the patient. who has to determine the medicine? Only because the patient is protesting, the doctor should not yield. Maybe a little sugar-coated pills can be given, that's fine. But the medicine has to be like that, no children, etc. So you find a way and means to push the medicine in the throat and not yield to the patient. So he should have, that means, persisted in a little, still further little attraction, etc. He also stopped it, see. But puja paatha, etc. Even parayana also. Parayana can bring some punya. Otherwise, nowadays everything is available on your TV. Oh, not TV, what is that? Computer. You can switch on all things, you can go on. You want Vedic chanting, also that is available. Yes, only you have to tap the proper website, that's all. Everything is available. So what? So, that is the... But the discovery has to be one's own. All puja, patha, parayana have their own role. Shastra only has given. But that doesn't mean all lifelong you can sit in KG class only. So you have to go to higher and higher classes. Finally the discovery of Swarupa. So therefore, so taking into account their stature, Jnani does all these so that his Shraddha in karma is confirmed. Beside that, performance of karma can bring some good to the humanity. Now suppose this Jnani is amidst the Mumukshus and Jidnyasu who are serious in gaining the Atma Jnana, Brahma Jnana. How should the Jnani conduct oneself? He says, Ultana. Better give up all karma and point out the defects of karma to those people so that they can take seriously Shravana, Manana, Ididhyasana. So the other context now, the Jnani amidst the Bubutsus or Jidnyasus or Mimukshus, how he should conduct. Esha madhye bubhutsunam yada tishthe tada punah bodhayaisham kriya sarvah dushayam stajato svayam. Eshaha punaha yada bubutsunam madhye tishthe tada esham bodhaya sarvaha kriyaha dushayan svayam ad api tejatu. Sandhi there, dushayan tejatu becomes dushayam tejatu. Dushayan, then anvaya, svayam, add api tejatu. Eshaha, this jnani, who has got nishtha. Punaha, further, yada, when, where is he? Bubhutsunam madhye tishte. When he is amidst the bubhutsus, who is bubhutsu? Bodhum ichhuhu bubhutsuhu. One who is desirous of gaining the knowledge. Bubhutsu also can be derived. Bhoktum ichhuhu bubhutsuhu. Who is bhoktum ichhuhu bubhutsu? बुभुक्षुः, इट इज नॉट बुभुत्सु, बुभुक्षुः, भोक्तुम् इच्छुः, बुभुक्षुः, वन हु इज डिजायरस ऑफ ईटिंग, बट हियर नॉट बुभुक्षुः, बुभुत्सुः, वन हु इज बोधुम् इच्छुः, वन हु हैज गॉट डिजायर टू गेन द नॉलेज. सो बुभुत्सु नाम मध्ये तिष्ठेत, व्हेन ही इज amidst the people who are serious in gaining the Atmajnana, so what he should do? Tada, then, esham bodhaya. Esham means bubhutsunam bodhaya. For knowledge of these people who would like to gain the knowledge, what he should do? Sarvaha kriyaha dushayan. Better let this jnani take to nivritti now. Withdraw from all the karmas, sarvaha kriyaha, all karmas. What are those all karmas? Shakayena manasa vacha, physical level, oral and mental level. Dushayan, pointing out their defects. So how they are defect means binding in nature. Swayamapi, himself, oneself also. Tejatu, let him give up the karma. So, jnani, whether performing the karma or giving up karma, depends on which context he is, amidst who, amidst what type of people he is. Ajnanis are there, let him do karma and demonstrate karma. If the bubukshus, bubutsus are there, not bubukshus, bubutsus are there, those who want to gain the knowledge, let him take to nivritti. So there is nothing wrong because he is not going to lose or gain on account of either of these two. A question may be asked, why should he do like this? For which an illustration is given. See, only because a jnani takes to karma for the benefit of the ajnanis doesn't mean that his knowledge goes and he loses his knowledge or comes to harm. Such a thing is not there, which is illustrated from the example of the world. Avidvadanusarena vrittir buddhasya yujyate स्तनंधयानुसारेण वर्तते तत्पितायतः अविद्वदनुसारेण बुद्धस्य वृत्तिः युज्यते यतः स्तनंधयानुसारेण पिता वर्तते यतः स्तनंधयानुसारेण तत्पिता वर्तते अविद्वद अनुसारेण बुद्धस्य वृत्तिः युज्यते. इसे बुद्धस्य वृत्तिः, वृत्ति मीन्स कंडक्ट इन टर्म्स ऑफ performing the karma, etc. Or lifestyle. Vritti also is lifestyle. Also the means of earning livelihood also is vritti. But here, lifestyle or conduct of the buddha means jnani. Avidvad anusarena, according to the need of the ignorant person. Need of the ignorant person doesn't mean what ignorant person is demanding, but what is beneficial to him. Because ignorant person may demand something which is totally detrimental to this person. That is not going to be catered to by jnani. But what is necessary for the ignorant person from his ultimate good, from that standpoint, avidvadavsana buddhasya vrittihi yujyate, is befitting, is proper. How? For this, an example is given from the word. Yataha, we find like this. What is that? Stanandhayanusarena tat pita vartate. स्तनंधयः एज सकलिंग, यू नो सकलिंग मीन्स ए बेबी स्टिल फीड्स ऑन मदर्स मिल्क. मे बी अ चाइल्ड हु इज क्रॉलिंग नाउ, मे बी 9 months और 10 months. हाउ डज द फादर बिहेव विद दिस चाइल्ड? Hello. And who is this father? He is 40 years old with a grown-up mustache, okay? And do you know what he does? He also crawls with the child. Like the child also he crawls. At times carries the child on the back. At times the child kicks the father. That's going to be told in the next scene. Suppose the same father after 20 years is kicked by the son. What will happen? So all let us say. See, when the child was 9 months, this fellow was playing, father was playing with the child, keeping on the chest, and child was kicking the. Now the scene has changed after 20 years. One fine evening, the son comes and shouts at the father, "I will kick you out of home." Will the father take it? What? Who will kick me out of home? Before that, the father kicks the son out of home. Look, 20 years back, the son has actually kicked the father on the chest. And the father was appreciating, was happy, because see how lively and kicking healthy the boy, baby is, and he was happy. Now the son has not kicked at all, only he has said what? "I will kick you out of home." He loses the temper. Had he inquired the cause, generally the son doesn't behave like this. What happened today? Why he should say like this? Oh, this fellow has gone in the wrong company. Before coming, the fellow had taken a peg and he could have taken to remedial measures. But what? You are kicking me? The fellow is. But astanandhayaha, when a suckling, the child, baby, who is still feeding on mother's milk, now crawling child, etc. What father does? So stanandhayanusarena, according to the whims and fancies of the suckling, the child, tatpita vartate, the father conducts oneself. He caters to the fancies of the child also. So that is what. So what is that? Father's conduct according to stanandhaya is explained in the next stanza. अधिक्षिप्तस्ताडितो वा बालेन स्वपिता तदा न क्लिश्नाति न कुप्येत बालं प्रत्युत लालये. बालेन अधिक्षिप्तः ताडितः वा स्वपिता तदा न क्लिश्नाति बालं प्रति न कुप्येत. बालं प्रति न कुप्येत उत लालये. उत लालये. This is the conduct of the father. What is it? Balena adhikshiptaha. This father is adhikshipta, means tiraskritaha. He is insulted or disregarded by the child. Innocent child, not a grown-up person. Innocent child. He is disregarded. So that is, he is disregarded or insulted by the child. Adhikshiptaha means tiraskritaha or avadnya. Avadnya is insult. Or taditaha va, beaten by the child. This innocent child, not knowing, he beats the child. Then what does his father do? Swapita tada. That is, the child, the father of the child, na krishnati, doesn't get afflicted. Na krishnati means klesham na apnoti. Oh, my child is insulting me. My child is beating me. Which child? Not 10 years or 15 years or 20 years. So only 9 months or hardly 1 year or so, the crawling one. So doesn't get afflicted. Nor na kuppeta, balam prati na kuppeta, doesn't get angry with the child. On the contrary, uta. Uta means on the contrary, lalaye, fondles the child. Which child? Which has insulted or kicked the father. Why? He knows the innocence of the child, so he doesn't know anything. So that also they say, bringing of children. They say, up to, that's what our sampradaya, our shastra says, a child up to the age of 5 should be pampered, should be treated like Maharaja, keep on the head and dance, whatever the child asks to do, do it. Up to the age of 5. From 6 to 16 or 18, treat the child as the slave. Command and make it obey. After 18, better behave like the friend. Nowadays, what is done? After 18 only, do this, do that. All counseling start after 18. And from 6 to 18, the children are let loose. You need not let loose. Only one channel TV is enough. What they see there is enough to spoil the children totally. And afterwards 18, don't do this, do this, etc. What is going to work afterwards? Nothing is going to work. That is the real way of bringing up the children. So first, when the innocent children, you can't command there, it will not work. So you dance to the tune of the kid up to 5. But afterward, strict discipline must be there. And once 18, leave them, because already programmed, because they will not behave wrongly as such. So anyway, but here, innocent child, the father just was, is not angry, just fondles. This is drishtanta. Similarly, how a jnani conducts darshtanta. Nindita-stuya-mano-va
vidvanadnairna-nindati
nastauti-kintu-tesham-syad yathā-bodhas-tathā-charet. Anvaya I will give next time. What it means is, similarly, a jnani, whether praised by ajnanis or condemned and criticized by ajnanis, he is unperturbed. On the contrary, conducts in such a way that they can get the benefit and strive for gaining the higher goals of life. That is how it will see.
Om Swasti Prajapya Paripalayantam.